Welcome to Young Tuition. Let's continue discussing basic issues in climate physics. Today, I'm going to investigate several popular infrared spectra in which CO2 absorption signal were miraculously strong and that can be perfectly simulated theoretically. Let's go and have fun. Before I show the spectra in question, I would like to introduce some background knowledge about absorption and emission spectra and how they are detected in lab. Broadly speaking, infrared CO2 spectra can be divided as absorption and emission, which can be further divided into continuous or discrete. For example, in this emission spectra from a flame with chemicals, both continuous and a discrete emission signal can be seen. But notice that the discrete emission peaks are built at the top of the continuous emission spectra. A discrete absorption peak is also called a resonant absorption peak. The frequency at its center is equal to the photon energy divided by the Planck constant H. If too many resonant absorption peaks are closely positioned or their line width increases, then such absorption spectra would appear as continuous envelope. In the case of gaseous samples such as CO2 in air, frequent molecule collisions and rotations could average out some anisotropic interactions such as dipole-dipole coupling, which could result in line narrowing, but also line shifting that in effect smooths some parts of the theoretically calculated discrete spectra. Under certain conditions, one can observe both absorption and emission signals at the same time. But as a rule of the thumb, absorption of CO2 gas can be observed at room temperature, as first demonstrated by Robbins, and while emission of the CO2 gas can only be detected at temperatures higher than a few hundred Kelvin. This implies that the upside-down absorption peak detected in transmission mode could be mixed up with an upward emission peak between 300 Kelvin and 500 Kelvin when CO2 gas is being measured. That's why it is unlikely or even impossible to observe the CO2 emission signal in the atmosphere where the temperature is below 300 Kelvin. Now, let me present the infrared spectra of CO2, which were reportedly as observed data. This is a big deal because the only criterion in physics has been the related experimental evidence since the great Galileo Galilei. So far, it would appear no one has bothered to further ask how these IR spectra were measured, let alone to speculate its origin. Well, this is understandable because most independent researchers like me cannot build a similar instrument and lift it either by a balloon or a satellite. By the way, this is similar to the study of the Standard Model and the gravitational waves, where no one could independently confirm the claims made by the owners of the instrument. Nevertheless, this doesn't mean I cannot evaluate the related infrared spectra of CO2. Based on my expertise and experiences I have accumulated since the 1980s, so let's have a closer look. This far infrared spectra was measured on July 7th, 2005 in the troposphere. Instrument used is called far infrared spectrometer in the troposphere, or FIRST for short. Notice the instrumental limit is under wave number 600 per centimeter. This is understandable because every spectrometer has its characteristic range of detection. Because the CO2 absorption peak associated with its molecular bending is centered at 15 micron or 667 per centimeter in wave number, one wouldn't expect FIRST could detect CO2 peak, which is, to be exact, in the mid or intermediate infrared range, as you can see from this firstly detected spectra by the FIRST. Yeah, that's right. From this IR spectra published in 2006 and 2009, however, a strong and wide CO2 peak appears. This is where I became suspicious when I first saw them a few years ago. Why? Because the water vapor contribution almost completely disappears between the wave number 600 to 700 per centimeter. Based on this first observation of the infrared absorption spectra of CO2 and water vapor by Robbins and Ashikness in 1898, as you can see from this figure, the CO2 absorption peak is always overlapped with that of water vapor. Besides, the CO2 absorption peak observed by looking down and the CO2 emission peak observed by looking up are exactly the same. This is impossible, as I will discuss next time. Now, let's look at this middle infrared spectrum, which was reported as a directly measured spectrum by using a spectrometer called REFIR, presumably far infrared PAD, by an Italian restaurant, by Italian research group. According to their instrumental specification, the measured range of the REFIR PAD is between wave number 100 to 1400 per centimeter. Therefore, the CO2 absorption peak centered at 667 per centimeter should be detectable, at least in principle. By reading their original paper carefully, I have realized that the distinct CO2 peak in their reported mid-infrared spectra was actually computer-simulated, rather than directly observed. How did I know that, you might ask? Well, to understand this detective story, one has to get familiar with the technique called the sounding that has been widely applied in atmospherical observations, both on the ground and in space from a satellite. It is noticed that such sounding observations are always challenging because they have to determine at least the four distributions from a single experiment. They are vertical atmospherical temperature distribution, vertical density of CO2 molecules distribution, vertical absorption coefficient distribution of CO2, or sometimes called the extinction coefficient, and the vertical density of aerosols, as well as the vertical distribution of water vapor VMR, or the volume mixing ratios, similar to the absolute humidity. Good heaven, how can they do it? They guess beforehand. A theoretically simulated IR spectra by invoking Schwarzschild equation for radiative transfer called forward model, an oversimplified vertical density distribution of CO2, and the US standard atmospherical temperature profile are used to guide the spectrometer what to do. What a joke. In short, this CO2 peak was digitally added on the detected atmospherical absorption spectra, as shown in this figure. That's why I call these infrared spectra as fabricated. If you wish to challenge my analysis, or you know someone who would rebuttal my argument, please let me know so that I will make a follow-up video. But please be polite as a gentleman or lady. By the way, I used to work in the same research field where Professor Harper and Dr. Wang Jing Garden did, namely magnetic resonance spectroscopy of electron and nuclear spins, except they used optical laser too. So I hope they would pay attention to this issue. Thank you for your viewing. See you next time.